What's up, guys? Chaos here. Today's video is powered by the Red Magic S. As gamers, we want everything tailored toward gaming. Why not your cell phone as well? Check this thing out. This phone has its own 4.0 ice active liquid cooling system with a turbo fan. The phone has its own liquid cooling system. Not only is this beast powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 865, but it also has 144 hertz refresh rate. It has a 6.65 eSport AMO LED display. It's huge. It's huge. It's vivid. It's bright. Storage, they've got you covered. Up to 256 gig. Battery life, they've got you covered. A 55 watt quick charge. But let's not forget, it's a gaming phone. It has shoulder triggers to enhance your gameplay. It has exclusive gaming optimization. This is a gamer's phone. Not to mention, guys, it just looks cool. New signature color, Sonic Silver Impulse. If you guys want to check out the Red Magic 5S, the link is at the top of the description. It is a gamer's phone. The phrase dumbest gun in every COD can be taken a lot of different ways when it comes to Call of Duty. Dumbest gun as in it's just stupid, it sucks. Or dumbest gun, it was so dumb overpowered that you were frustrated with it. Well, today, that's where we're focusing. Just a little too powerful to the point where it's flat out dumb. What's up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the series. Today, we are going to go from COD 4 all the way through Modern Warfare 2019, checking out the absolute dumbest gun in every Call of Duty. And you may think you know where I'm going with some of these, but guess what? I'm going to throw some wild cards in on you today. So you let me know in the comments what you think the dumbest gun in every COD is. Drop a like, turn those notifications on, and if you want a chance to win a next-gen console, I'm giving multiple next-gen consoles away this fall, click the link at the top of the description. Now let's get into it. Okay, as promised, COD 4, the RPD. Now you may have thought I was going to put the M16 on here, but honestly, the M16 wasn't nearly as dumb as the RPD. Yes, the M16 was overpowered, but at least it only had a 30-round mag, and you actually had to learn the timing of the burst. The RPD, on the other hand, it was insane. It was a 100-round LMG. It would kill in 3 shots from any distance, 2 with stopping power, and it fired at 700 rounds per minute. And it had super clean sights, and if you put a foregrip on it, the recoil was gone. You could delete people from insane distances with the RPD, and in the remastered version of COD 4, that spam was even worse than the original. So sure, the M16 may have been overpowered, but the RPD was dumb. Next up, this one's not gonna shock anybody, it's a default answer, but it's the truth. World at War, the MP40. An SMG that hits for 59 damage without stopping power? I mean, come on. I don't know about that. It was ridiculous. It killed in 2 shots up close, 4 shots at long range, and you didn't even need to put stopping power on it. If you did, well, it was ultra dumb. It was by far the best gun in World at War. It wasn't even close. With its great damage and handling, it was just way too versatile to pass up. If you wanted to do well in World at War back in the day, you used the MP40. That's just the way it was. Now we've arrived at Modern Warfare 2, one of my favorite guns in COD history, the ACR. Often called the best assault rifle in the game, and for good reason. This baby fired at 800 rounds per minute, it killed in 4 to 5 shots without stopping power, and it had zero, zilch, not a recoil. If you were running the ACR with stopping power, well, you would delete people everywhere. They wouldn't even be able to tell what hit them. The ACR was so good, but unfortunately, there's another ACR that kind of stole its thunder. We'll talk about that one later. And here we are at Black Ops 1. Another pick that's not gonna shock anybody, the FAMAS. Blatantly overpowered on launch day, and even after they nerfed it, by far the best gun in the game. This assault rifle had one of the fastest fire rates in the game. It killed in 3 shots up close, 4 at range, gave it the fastest time to kill of any automatic in the game, even outclassing the SMGs. I don't know how Treyarch let the gun through testing, nor do I know how they never patched it out. I mean, they patched the recoil at one point, but they never touched the damage. That was the biggest problem with the gun from the beginning. Well, can't do anything about it now, it's gone. The point is, the Black Ops 1 FAMAS was by far the dumbest gun in the game. Now we're at Modern Warfare 3. Shocker, shocker, the ACR 6.8. Considered again, the best assault rifle in the game. And you would have thought they changed something with Modern Warfare 2, but no, sir. It returned. Some even argue it was even better. The fire rate was decreased to 700 rounds per minute, but the damage was cranked up to an insane degree. It would kill in 3 to 4 shots to the body, and if you landed at least one headshot, it was a 2-shot kill, making it one of the only automatics in the game that could actually 2-tap.
It also maintained zero recoil, great clean iron sights, and it allowed you to load up other attachments like extended mags or suppressors. It was dumb. It was dumb. It was dumb. Black Ops 2, the KSG. I adore the gun, but it was kind of dumb. I mean, it was the first slug shotgun in COD history, and it made waves in the community. It was basically like handling a DMR. You had to be precise with it, but if you could hit your shots, well, it dealt stupid damage. It killed in one shot from any distance, pretty much, especially if you put the long barrel on it. The KSG was so much fun and so satisfying to use, and it was such a dramatic change of pace from most COD shotguns. So, when I say the KSG was dumb, I am saying that with pure love. Call of Duty Ghosts. The Chainsaw. Speaking of guns that had a change of pace, the Chainsaw fits that bill perfectly. The LMG did not have a proper aim down sight feature, but instead, you just had super tight hip fire spread. It fired at 857 rounds per minute, or 1,000 with rapid fire, and it killed in 3 to 5 shots. The LMG movement speed wasn't great, but it made up for it with the fact that you didn't really have to stop to ADS or worry about sprint out times. You could just run around holding the trigger down and mop up kill after kill. On more open maps, the Chainsaw sucked, but on smaller maps like Strike Zone, it was one of the dumbest guns in the game. Now we've come to the epitome of dumb. Advanced Warfare. The Battle 27 Obsidian Steed. Do I even really need to go into detail why this gun was busted? By far the best gun in AW, for multiple reasons. Handling, time to kill, versatility, you name it. But then you put the Obsidian Steed variant on it, and it's even worse. It beefed up the damage at a slight fire rate cost, but the time to kill was still higher than the base version. Plus, it was a supply drop exclusive. And the drop rates? Well, they were low. I don't know why, but they were. The Battle Obsidian Steed was by far the dumbest gun in Advanced Warfare, and I don't think anybody is going to argue with me on this one. Black Ops 3, the Breccia. Seriously, screw this gun. I don't even want to talk about it. It's my video. You know why it's dumb. I know why it's dumb. Let's move on. Infinite Warfare, the MV4. Shocker! It was a bizarre gun, actually, to talk about, because when you look at the stats, it wasn't that impressive. The damage and fire rate were pretty average for an assault rifle in Infinite Warfare, but what made it so broken was the handling. The MP4 had great handling speeds, no recoil, plus some of the cleanest iron sights in COD history, not just Infinite Warfare, making it by far the easiest gun in the game to use. Now, despite IW having tons of advanced movement options and a whole arsenal of cool weapons, a lot of people just ran in corners, sat in corners, next to walls with the MP4 because it was the easiest gun to use, and even when you looked at pub stompers and competitive players, a lot of them were using the MV4 as well because it was reliable. It was kind of dumb. COD World War II. Hello, Lewis. Yeah, it's one of the best LMGs in COD history. And I don't know if that makes people happy. I don't know. It would kill in 3 to 4 shots. Only fired at 500 rounds per minute, but it had very high cover penetration, super clean iron sights, a big magazine, very low recoil, and super fast handling. The LMGs in general in COD World War II, they were a little strong, mainly because of their fast handling, and the Lewis just made that issue more obvious because of its great damage to go with it. COD World War II had some really good elements, and it had some really bad elements. I'll let you guys discuss in the comments whether you think the gun balance felt good or bad in that game. Black Ops 4, the Mozu Skull Splitter. Now, I've done my fair share of complaining about this gun in the past, and I don't know how Treyarch thought it was a good idea ever to put it in the game. The Mozu was a 6-shot revolver. It was okay on its own, but if you put the Skull Splitter on it, well, it became a 1-shot kill to the head, regardless of where you are on the map. You could literally just spam 6 shots out of it, and if any one of them hit the head, it was an insta-kill. Now let's think about this for a second, let's break it down. On one hand, you could use a sniper rifle that was a 1-shot kill but had a super slow rate of fire and a long reload animation, or you could just use this revolver that had great handling, super fast animations, and it was a 1-shot kill to the head at any distance, and then you could just spam the 6 shots out. The gun was dumb. I don't care what anybody says. The gun was dumb. And wrapping up our session today, Modern Warfare 2019, the M4. Now, I consider putting the Bruin LMG here, honestly, but the Bruin has been nerfed pretty hard, and it's not getting nearly the playtime it was. However, the M4 is still right there in the top tier of Warzone weapons, and it's the best AR in normal multiplayer as well. It's an accurate weapon. It's versatile. In multiplayer, you can kit the M4 to move as quickly as an SMG while maintaining its great damage. In Warzone, you can kit it to be incredibly accurate while keeping excellent close and mid-range damage. The M4 was the most used gun in the game on day one, and now that Black Ops Cold War is around the corner, guess what? It still is. I mean, it's not spammed as much as it was, but I think the M4 is definitely the best overall gun in the game, and to me, well, some people would consider that dumb. And there you have it. Those are the dumbest guns in every single Call of Duty. You let me know if you agree or disagree, and I'll see you guys soon.